हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज डॉक्टर श्वेता गोयल एंड यू आर वाचिंग इंजीनियरिंग मास्टर द फाइनेस्ट वे टू लर्न द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल एंड फिजिक्स. सो हियर दिस इज अवर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर, नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, दैट इज एसी ऑल्टरनेटिंग करंट थ्रू रजिस्टर, कैपेसिटर एंड इंडक्टर. इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल स्टडी अबाउट हाउ एसी इज परफॉर्म इन रजिस्टर, इंडक्टर एंड कैपेसिटर. सो हियर फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल टॉक अबाउट AC through resistor. Okay, so AC through resistor, let's suppose this is a AC terminal, this is a switch and a resistor is connected. We can also make like this. Okay, resistor is connected here. Now the voltage terminal VT, terminal voltage is VT. This is a switch. When switch is open, the circuit is open, and when switch is closed, the circuit is closed. We are able to get the output. So IT current is flowing through this VT, and the resistance voltage is VR. VT is equal to VR because both are current connected in parallel. Okay. Now VT, because this is AC, so VT equals to Vm sin omega t, or we can also say equal to VR. Okay, now according to Ohm's law, okay, because this is a closed circuit, so according to Ohm's law, what happened? IT, because I equals to V upon R, so here IT equals to VT upon R. So we can write the value of VT, that is Vm sin omega t upon R, that is we can say resistance current also. Okay, so comparing IT with standard equation. Okay, standard equation. So what is the standard equation? That is I equals to Im sin omega t plus phi. So we are comparing with this equation. So what we get? We get that Im is Vm upon R, okay, and phi is zero. So we can say in resistance phi is zero, so we can say phase angle is zero. So V and I are same phase, because in resistance the phase angle is zero. So we can say V and I are in same phase. Okay, now if we talk about the phase circuit figure, or we can say if we talk about the waveform, this is a waveform. Red color waveform is from voltage, and black current waveform is for current. So both are in same phase. So maximum and minimum value of phase current will be same. So maximum value at the same time pi by 2, and minimum value at the same time pi by 2. So this is a waveform for the resistance, AC in resistance. If we talk about the phasor diagram, so we can also make the phasor diagram like this. This is a reference value, a reference angle. So this is VR, and I are also in the phasor of this, and the angle is omega. So this is the phasor of resistance. Now if we talk about power, what will be the power through this? Okay, so instantaneous power given by instantaneous power is given by P equals to V into I. Okay, so we can put the value of here Vm sin omega t into Im sin omega t. So if we into this Vm Im sin square omega t. Okay, we can also write here there is some trigonometry in this formula. So Vm sin omega t cos omega t can be written as 1 minus cos omega t upon 2. Okay, so we can also, if we open this, Vm Im upon 2 minus Vm Im cos 2 omega t upon 2. Okay, so this is your instantaneous power. And if we talk about average power, okay, so average power consumption over one cycle, okay, so average power consumption over one cycle will be like P average equals to what will be Pm Im upon 2, that is Vm upon root 2, because this is the RMS value, and we can also write Im upon root 2. It becomes RMS value, so we can also write P average will be Vrms into Irms, because this is cos omega t. Cos omega t is 0 because of the one cycle, that is 2 pi. So cos 2 pi equals to 0. So we have only the Vm upon Im. So Vm upon Im is Vm upon Im 2. We can also write root 2. So Vm upon root 2 into Im upon root 2. This is the value of Irms or Vrms. So we can write it Vrms into Irms, or we can also write it I square R watt. So this is your average power for resistance and capacitor. Okay, so we can also make a graph for power here. This is current and this is voltage. So power will be at like this. So Vm Im upon 2. So this is a graph for power. Now we will talk about, take a screenshot for this, or you can note it down. Now we will talk about AC through pure inductance circuit. Okay, so please stay tuned. We will talk about many AC circuit form here. So second is AC through inductance. So pure AC, we are talking about pure AC through inductance. Okay, pure AC through the inductance. So our circuit will be like this. This is switch and this is inductance. Inductor is there, and VT terminal voltage, IT is current through this. Switch is there. If switch is open, current will be open circuit. Circuit will be open and no current will be flow. If switch is closed, circuit will be closed and current will be flow. So here angle is phi and there is a current of VL. Okay, now VT is Vm sine omega t, because this is AC circuit, so this is a VT sine omega t. Now according to Faraday's law, because there is an induction, Faraday's law work, so we can write it where there is a resistance, Ohm's law work, when there is a inductance, Faraday's law work, Faraday's or Lenz law. Okay, Faraday's law of EMI. What is given? Self-inductance. I hope you all know what is self-inductance. Self-inductance is given by E equals to minus L di by dt. Minus sign is only for the direction. So L di by dt we can write it. Okay. So at all instant VT is equal and opposite to self-induced. Okay, at all instant VT, this terminal voltage is equal and opposite, because this is EMF generated, that is minus L by DT, minus L di by DT, because this is a Faraday's law of self-induction. So it is equal and opposite to induce. So VT is always equal and opposite. So we can also write VT equals to minus E, this minus E. So we can also write minus L di by DT. Okay, so it can be L di by dt. Now here, from here, di equal to E. This is E, or we can say VT. Okay, so we can say VT. So VT upon L dt. So we can put the value of Vt, that is Vm sin omega t here. So here it will happen di equals to Vm sin omega t upon L dt. Okay, so integrate both side, because we have to remove this dt sign, so we have to integrate both side. What will happen? It will di integration of di integration of Vm upon L sin omega t dt. Okay, now what will happen? This is a constant value, so we can write it I, because this is di is I and this is a constant value Vm omega L and under root of sin omega t dt. So I equals to Vm upon L sin omega t. We can also write integration of sin omega t, that is cos omega t upon omega. Okay, because sin omega t, that is cos omega t upon omega. So the limit will be 0 to pi by 2. Sin 0 is 0, the cos 0 is 1. So, or we can also remove the limit, or we can say here cos omega t, we can also write omega t plus pi by 2, or omega sin omega t minus pi by 2. So here omega t minus pi by 2 is minus cos omega t plus cos omega t. So we can write it omega Vm cos omega t sin omega t plus pi by 2 over. Okay, we can also write it omega t minus pi omega t, or omega can be here. Okay, now what will happen? I am doing with the next different color, so it will be very helpful to you. So if we compare this with the standard equation, comparing with Im sin omega t plus phi. So here Im is Vm over omega L, this value, and we can also write Vm upon XL, and phi is minus pi by 2. Okay, so it is minus 90 here, 90, because minus is, so omega t minus pi by 2 is minus cos omega t, so we can write it here. So minus pi by 2 is here. Okay, now from here you can say current is minus pi by 2 with respect to voltage, or we can say current lags by 90 degree. Okay, so I can write it I lags by 90 degree. Okay, so this is a circuit diagram or the waveform. We will talk about waveform now. So now this is a waveform for inductive inductance through the pure AC circuit, AC through the pure inductive circuit. So Vm is going through this like this, and Im is a minus 5 degree. So it is start from the pi by 2 direction. So we can also make like this. So this is a minus pi by 2. So we can make like this. And if we talk about phasor, so this is a reference value, that is Vm. And it is minus pi by 2 in electrical angle. Minus is always a clockwise direction. So we can also write like this. So this is Im angle. So this is 90 degree phase angle. Now one term is initiated from this, that is inductive reactance. So what is inductive reactance? Inductive reactance basically defined as the opposition offered by an inductance of a circuit to the flow of an AC current, जो आपके AC current को flow होने में oppose करेगा. जैसे हम resistance की बात करते हैं, तो resistance क्या होता है? Resistance is the property of a resistor which oppose the flow of current. So here inductive reactance is basically a inductance property, inductor property which oppose the flow of current, basically, which oppose the flow of AC current. Okay, so this is inductive reactance, and because this property is just like resistance, so measured in ohm. So how we can find it? Im equals to, from the equation, Im equals to Vm upon XL, और वी कैन से Vm अपॉन ओमेगा एल. सो एक्सएल इक्वल्स टू ओमेगा एल और ओमेगा इज 2πfL. सो वी कैन ऑल्सो से लाइक दिस. तो दिस इज अ इंडक्टिव रिएक्टेंस. नाउ पावर थ्रू द इंडक्टेंस. ओके नाउ वी विल टॉक अबाउट पावर. सो instantaneous power is given by V into I, just same as the resistance. So V into I, so here V is Vm sin omega t and I am sin, here sin omega t is minus pi by 2. Okay, now what will happen, this will be minus pi by 2, we can also write minus cos omega t. So minus Vm Im sin omega t, cos sin omega t minus pi by 2 can be written as cos omega t minus cos omega t. So we take minus here. So here Vm Im upon 2 sin omega t cos omega t is sin 2 omega t upon 2. Okay. So some trigonometry is here. So here sin 2 omega t can be written. Average power consumption in one cycle, we talk about always average power, because the AC circuit the power is will be positive and negative, so it is always zero. So average power consumption over one cycle will be P average, that is integration will be 0 to 2 pi, because the average power is 0 pi by 2, the pi by 2 pi and 3 pi by 2 and 2 pi. So average cycle will be, one cycle will be 0 to 2 pi. So 0 to 2 pi here, minus Vm Im upon 2 sine 2 omega t. Okay, now equal to 0. 2 omega t, or we can say omega 2 omega t d omega t. Okay, because we are doing integration, so d omega t term is here. So it, if we do it, that we get 0. So average power consumption is 0. So we can also make like this. This is your voltage. Okay, now so this is your current and this is your voltage, and average power will be this. So P average will be D. So we can also say stored release energy. Okay, this is your energy stored. We can also say energy stored in this time, energy stored, and in this time energy release. Okay, so we can also say inductor never consume power, because average power is zero. So it can store energy and release energy, but it can never consume any power. Okay, now we will talk about AC through the pure capacitance circuit. So here we will talk about AC through the pure capacitance circuit. So this is a circuit diagram, this is a switch, this is a capacitor is connected in a, this is a pure capacitor we are considering. So here plus Q, minus Q charge, and this is your terminal VC, and this is your terminal voltage, and this is your IT, and switch is open, the current will be open. So at instant VT equals to Vm sin omega t. Okay, now charge Q equals to C into VT, because capacitor has charge, so we will talk about charge. So CQ equals to C into VT, so we can put the value of VT here. So V m sin omega t, we can put it here. Now the current is a rate of flow of charge. What is current? Current is rate of flow of charge. This is a very basic concept of current, so we can write it here, I equals to dq by dt. Okay, now we can put the value of Q here. So D upon DT, Q value is C Vm sin omega T I. Okay, now what will we do? We do I equals to C Vm is constant dt sin omega t. So dt dt d upon dt of sin omega t, that is c vm d upon dt sin omega t, that is omega cos omega t. This is the trigonometrical formula. So here c omega m, so we can also write it vm upon 1 upon c omega cos omega t, or we can also write this cos omega t term, that is vm upon, we can c omega cw, we can write it xc. Okay, xc I will talk about for this. So here sin omega t plus pi by 2, because this is a positive term, so sin omega t plus pi by 2 here. Now comparing with standard equation, it equals to im sin omega t plus pi by 2 plus phi. So here im is vm upon xc and phi equals to pi by 2. So we can say the, because plus positive, so we can say current leads by 90 degree. Okay, so we can say current leads by 90 degree in capacitor. Okay, now what will we do? We will do the waveform. So here is a waveform, that is I red color is shown the Vm sin omega t, and a green color is the for Im sin omega t. And Im sin omega t started from the very beginning, from very beginning with respect to Vm sin omega t, or we can say Im is started from minus pi by 2. Okay, we can also say like this. So in pi by 2 it is we can say Vm is lags. Okay, so now if we talk about the phasor diagram, this is a reference angle and then this is Vm, and if Im is IC is we can say VC, and if IC is leading, so we can make the positive angle here. This is omega and this is your IC 90 degree. So this is your current, and one term is defined from this formula, that is capacitive reactance. Like a inductive reactance, that is capacitive reactance. So on comparing from the standard equation, we get Im, that is Vm upon 1 upon omega c. So if omega c, we can write xc. So here xc equals to 1 upon omega c. So omega is 2 pi fc, so we can write xc equals to 1 upon 2 pi fc. Okay, now this is also a property of capacitance which oppose the flow of current in the circuit. Okay, so this is a capacitance property, so capacitive reactance is there. It is also measured in ohm. Now we will talk about the power in capacitance. So power in capacitance here, so instantaneous power is given by V into I. So we will put the value of here Vm sin omega t into Im sin omega t plus pi by 2, because Im is leading in the capacitor. So here Vm Im sin omega t, or we can write sin omega t plus pi by 2 is cos omega t, because this is positive. Now Im Vm cos omega t sin omega t can be written as sin 2 omega t upon 2. So average power will be here, P average will be here. So P average, that is 0 to 2 pi, because over one cycle. So 0 to 2 pi Vm Im by 2, Vm Im by 2 sin omega t d omega t, we can write. So here average power will be 0 to 2 pi Vm Im upon 2 sin omega t d omega t, or we can say over one cycle. This is a waveform over one cycle. So it is energy release, energy consume, energy release, energy consume. So we can also say it also never consume power. Okay, capacitor also never consume power, it always release and store the energy. So this is all for the AC through the power AC circuit, AC current through the प्योर इंडक्टेंस, प्योर कैपेसिटेंस एंड प्योर इंडक्टेंस. कैपेसिटेंस एंड प्योर रेजिस्टेंस सर्किट एंड वी ऑल्सो टॉक अबाउट द पावर. इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेरी रिगार्डिंग दिस सेशन स्टूडेंट प्लीज कमेंट मी इन अ कमेंट बॉक्स. आई विल एक्सप्लेन ऑल योर क्वेरीज. सो थैंक यू, गुड डे एंड टेक केयर. प्लीज स्टे ट्यून फॉर द नेक्स्ट वीडियोज एंड प्लीज सब्सक्राइब एंड शेयर दिस चैनल.